You're highly welcome, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm glad that you just clicked, you know, to watch it. I would like us to go straight forward into today's teaching. Let's go into the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 7. 2 Chronicles, chapter number 7. Let's start reading from verse number 14. It said, "If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land." So right here we are saying that what? That the Most High, the Most High, the Elohim of what? Of a people, said here, if my people, that is to say he has a people, the Most High Yahuwah has a people. He said, if my people, which, now listen, he said, which are called by my name. So these people are going to be called by his name. Now you get it. And this is very key, because we need to know what people, which people are the people that are called by the name of Yahuwah. Now, because it is going to be vital for we to be able to identify the people which are, you know, the people who are what? Who are the people of the Most High? Who are the people of what? Of Yahuwah. Because he said, if my people, which are called by my name, then that means there is a people that are being called by the name of our Heavenly Father Yahuwah, right? So now, and these people are the tribe of what? Of Yahuda. The tribe of Yahuda are the people who are called by the name of Yahuwah. What Yahuda means in the Hebrew, it means what? It means worshippers of Yahuwah. So now this passage of the scripture is saying that what? If my people which are called by my name, the name of our Heavenly Father is Yahuwah. And the name of the people which are called by his name are the tribe of Yahuda. So you see the what? You see the connection that is there. And when you go into the Hebrew language, the meaning of the term, the meaning of this name Yahuda, it means what? Worshippers of what? Of Yahuwah. Now I'm going to show you something that happened. Let's go into the book of Isaiah for we to see what the Father said about what? About his name. Now let's go into the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter number 42. Isaiah chapter 42 from verse number 8. He said there, "I am Yahuwah. That is my name, and my esteem will I not give to another, neither my praise to any graven image." So you see that our Heavenly Father Yahuwah pronounced his name. Now this, now when you read your Bible, you're going to see Lord in capital letter in that place. But originally, this is not what is there, because we need to go by the Hebrew. When you go to the concrete, you know, when you go to the root Hebrew, the Paleo Hebrew, that was, you know, the name that was here, you know, the four Hebrew letters that was here before this time is what is the Yod, the He, the Waw, and the He. Now, these four Hebrew letters, when you pronounce it out, what you're going to get is what is the name of our Heavenly Father, which is the name of Yahuwah. And now, the meaning of this term, Yahuwah, it means what is, it means He, the self-existing one. He who exists. Or just the self-existing one. So now he's saying in the book of 2 Chronicles that what? That if my people who are called by my name, that is the people, the tribe of Yahuda, the worshippers of Yahuwah, so because they have this connection with him, direct connection with him. So they say, he said that what? If these people will humble themselves and turn away from their wicked ways. Now let's go, let me show you something in the book of Exodus for me to show you the meaning of what? The meaning of the name of Yahuwah. Because already I told you that what? That the name, the meaning of the name Yahuda means what? Means worshippers of Yahuwah. And the meaning of the term Yahuwah means self-existing one. You know, so now go to, with me into the book of Exodus chapter number 3. Exodus chapter number 3. Let's start reading from verse 13 to see the meaning of what? Of the name of Yahuwah. So in verse 13 it says, "And Moses said unto Elohim, Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel and shall say unto them, The Elohim of your fathers hath sent me unto you, and they shall say unto me, What is his name? What shall I say unto them?" So Moses did not even know the name of the one that was sending him. Now, listen to what he said in verse 14. Say, "And Elohim said unto Moses, I am that I am. So you see that what that he is giving Moses the meaning of what of his name. Now this name now is in the Hebrew, it means what? It means Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya, meaning the self-existing one. And that is what pronounced as what as Yahuwah. Now let's see, let me show you something. He said what? I am that I am has sent me. Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am Ahaya hath sent me unto you. Now listen to verse 15. He said, and Elohim said unto Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, Yahuwah Elohim of your fathers. So you see that what that the same name he told Isaiah, that he told Isaiah in the book of Isaiah chapter number 42 from verse 8. The same name he told Isaiah, because that is his name. He told Isaiah that what? I am Yahuwah, that is my name. And here he's telling Moshe also that what? That the Elohim of your father, Yahuwah Elohim of your fathers, have what? Have sent me unto what? Unto you. You know, tell them that what? Yahuwah. So meaning that what? The term Yahuwah, which is when you say, you know, because here now he's giving him his real name. And now, before this time, he gave him the meaning of his name, which means I am that I am Ahaya, Asha Ahaya, which is the meaning of the term Yahuwah, of his name Yahuwah. You know, so now we are saying that the Most High is saying that what? That if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves. So those people that are called by the name of the Most High, Yahuwah, are the tribe of Yehuda. So because the term Yehuda means what? Worshippers of what? Of Yahuwah. And Yahuwah, the word Yahuwah, the name Yahuwah simply means what? Means the self-existing one. Or as they put it here, I am that I am. You know, he is the self-existing one. So you see the meaning of it now. So now let's go into the book of John for me to be able to show you that what that the Most High Yahuwah, our Heavenly Father Yahuwah, through his word, he has everyone that comes, you know, that is coming, that he sent them on what? With his own name. That is to say, we talk about people like Yeremiyahu. You see the Yahu in his name, you know, because these are messengers of what? Of Yahuwah. These are those that were sent by what? By Yahuwah. Now we are going to see about the, you know, we see a lot of people, you know, that are what? That are bearing, that are having the name of Yahuwah in them. So the tribe of Yehuda is just like, you know, the collective, you know, the place where there are so many, you know, the Yahus, you know, the Yahus. So when you talk about, you know, Yeremiyahu, you talk about Yeshayahu, you know, all these people are what are the tribe, from the tribe of Yehuda, because this is like their home where they are full, you know. So it said that if my people who are called by my name, because all of them were doing what? We are called by his name. So now let's go straight forward into the book of John. I want to show you what the Mashiach said in the book of John, chapter number 5. John chapter number 5, let's start reading from verse 43. Say, I come in my Father's name. So you see that Yahushua, who is the Word, came in the Father's name. Yeremiyahu, who is Jeremiah, who they call Jeremiah, he has the Father's name in him. But here, the Mashiach is telling us something here. He said he come in his Father's name. That is to say, the name of our Heavenly Father Yahuwah is what is in his name. So we are seeing three set of names here now. We see the name Yahuwah, which means the self-existing one. We are seeing the tribe of Yehuda, which means worshippers of Yahuwah. And now we are seeing the name Yahushua, which means what? Which means Yahuwah is my salvation. That is to say, you're seeing three names that are attached to what? To Yahuwah. Because what? Because these names are the ones that are what? That are like messengers in the term of the tribe. We talk about what the tribe of Yehuda, because it's like the home of the worshippers, those who believe on Yahuwah, those who put their trust on what? On Yahuwah, those who, you know, the worshippers of Yahuwah. And now we're seeing the Son of the Most High Yahuwah, that is the only begotten Son of the Most High, saying that he comes in his Father's name. And now when we check, we need to know what is his Father's name. Like I showed you in the book of Exodus chapter number 3. He said his name is what? Yahuwah. And also in the book of Isaiah chapter number 42 from verse 8, he said, I am Yahuwah. That is my name. My glory, that is my esteem, will I not give to any graven image. So he proclaimed his name. You know, because I hear some people out there say, oh, his name is unpronounceable. Do not pronounce it. You know, these are the Jews. Anybody that tells you that the name is unpronounceable, these are the converts. Those people, you know, nothing. Just like, you know, what happened, you know, during the time of Moses. You know, Moses himself, you know, what happened? When he was about to go meet when he was about to go deliver the message to the children of, he never knew the name of our Heavenly Father, right? You know, so you see that he inquired about the name before he was sent to go and tell them what the name is. Is it? So all these them Jews, you know, the Yahudim, they are not Jews. They are not Jews. These people are worshippers of Yahuwah. They were born worshippers of Yahuwah. They didn't need know nothing to convert to know any other. What converts to what? When they were born to be what? When they were born to be worshippers of Yahuwah. You see it? So what they are trying to do, you know, is trying to say, oh, the name is unpronounceable. You know, because I hear some of them to say, oh, the name is what is unpronounceable. Those people that say that are the Jews. Those people are those what? The converts. The ones that the Jews of Jews, even not the direct Jews, you know, because the original ones, the tribe, the people that are called by the name of our Heavenly Father, they definitely had to call on the name of Yahuwah, because his name is what? Because his name is in them. They are what? This is who they are. You know, this is part of their life. You get it? This is part of their life. This is what they are, because the more they call it, the more things they become. You get it? Pronouncing his name, you know, is a powerful thing, you know, to them. So now the people who are trying to tell the people not to pronounce the name, those people are afraid of that particular name. This is why they are doing what they are trying to do, to tell the people not to call it. You see it? Yahushua himself is saying that what? He comes in his Father's name. He come in his Father's name. So how is he going to come in his Father's name if that name is unpronounceable? So what is he saying in that place is, when you call my name, what you are automatically doing is you are calling on the Father's name. And this is the secret. Most of them do not even know that when you pronounce the Hebrew name of the Messiah, what you are automatically doing is you are calling on our Heavenly Father. You know what? And that was even a very big blow to them. You know, they never wanted it. So they had to get rid of him, you know, because they never wanted people to do what? To call on the name of Yahushua, because some of them already knew that what? When you are calling the name of Yahushua, what you are automatically doing is calling on our Heavenly Father. Because this is why Yahushua came, to do what? Because you remember what they did before. They made it what? They made it a kind of, they banned people from using the Hebrew name of our Heavenly Father, you know, in the public or speaking it out. They make it, you know, a kind of a taboo, you know, to pronounce that name, you know, because when you pronounce it, you know, to them, it is an advantage to them, you know, so they made it in fact, they made the name to do what? People stopped using that name. Why? Because they were afraid of that particular name. So something happened during those days. The Most High had to send somebody to come in his own name in order to do what? In order to restore the glory, the esteem of his name. And when Yahushua came, Yahushua now did what? He came in the Father's name in order to do what? To restore mankind to their previous position. So what happened is, now when you call on the name of Yahushua, what you are doing is you are by extension doing what? Calling on the name of the Father. And this is why you see most of them are what? Many of them were against what? The particular Hebrew name of the Messiah. Because they knew that the more you call on that Hebrew name, what happened is you are drawing the power of our Heavenly Father in order to do what? In order to pull down all these strongholds whatsoever that is around you. You get it? And they never wanted it. So they wanted people to keep silent to it. This is why they say, oh, the name is unpronounceable. You know, do not pronounce the name. You know, when Yahushua himself came here in the name of his Father, in the name of our Heavenly Father, which is Yahuwah, and we see the people who are called by what? By the name of our Heavenly Father. I mean, how can somebody be called by the name of our Heavenly Father and this them Jews on Jews
say that the name is unpronounceable. You see the way these people are twisting the whole thing. They are the ones, you know. Now I tell you something, you know, what they are trying to do is to forbid people from pronouncing that name, because it is for their own advantage when people stop using the name of our Heavenly Father Yahuwah. Because the more you pronounce it, the more the kingdom of darkness are what are in trouble. You get it? So they don't want people to use it. So what happened is they banned people from doing it. Let me show you something that happened in the book of Acts of Apostles. In the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter number 4. So now, what is going on here? They are talking about the name of Yahushua. You get it, the Hebrew name of Yahushua, which the Kepha, that is Peter and John, performed a miracle on. You know, so now what happened is, after they performed this miracle, they've been seeing so much wonders, miracle being performed in that Hebrew name of the Messiah. So now, watch what these people did. Remember, these people now are what are Jews, converts, not the Yahudim. These people are not Yahudim, but they are simply what? They are simply converts. Those who converted, we have convert of converts. You know, there are people who converted to be Jews, the original Jews who converted to be Jews, and there's another ones that converted to be the Jews of Jews. Now we are talking about what? We are talking about the Jews of Jews that converted, you know, during the time of what? Of the Mashiach. You know, so now these people, now look at what they are planning. Look at what they are trying to do against the name of the Messiah and the reason why they are doing it. Now listen to what happened in verse 17. It said, but that it spread no further, talking about what? Talking about the Hebrew name of the Messiah, because that same Hebrew name of the Messiah was the name that was that Kepha and John performed miracle with. You know, this was the same name that they performed. So now listen to what they say, but that it spread no further, that the name of Yahushua spread no further. Said, let us strictly threaten them that they speak henceforth to no man in this name. In the name of what? In the name of Yahushua. Why? Because they were afraid of that name. They knew that what that the name inside of it, it's embodied. The name of Yahuwah is embodied. That is to say, it's in the name of what? It's in the name of Yahushua. So when you call the name Yahushua, you're automatically calling on the name of the Father. So they had to concord and plan something against this Hebrew name of the Messiah. Now listen to what they did. They say, and they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of what? Of Yahushua. So do you see where these people are going? So this is to show you how these crafty people are doing, what are planning. So I'm here to tell you that what? That there are three. Listen, the name Yahuwah means what? He who exists, the self-existing one. You know, that was why he declared the meaning of his name, you know, to Moshe. You know, because Moshe did not know about his name, so he declared the meaning of his name to what? To Moshe. And now he said that what? If my people who are called by my name, talking about those who were born. He's not talking about no Jews, no Jews convert at this time, you know. He said the people who are called by my name, these people were born to be what? Born in what? As a Yahudim. And Yahudim, people who were born as Yahudim are what? Are worshippers of Yahuwah. Automatically, you don't need no converts. So now there are people who were converted into that. So now those people who were converted into what? Into Yahudim were the ones that wiped up the name of our Heavenly Father. You know, they made the people to stop using the name of our Heavenly Father. And now what happened is they banned it. So Yahushua, which is the Hebrew name of the Messiah, he had to come in the name of his Father in order to restore the dignity, the esteem of that name. Now when you call on the Hebrew name of the Messiah, what you are automatically doing is you are automatically calling on the name of the Father. So this is the connection that is going to do what? Bring you back to where you belong. That is why the Father said what? Will humble themselves and turn away from their wicked ways. That means you have to obey his voice. Turn away from their wicked way. This is why, you know, you see that what there's a lot of this is a way of escape. Why? Because those people who concocted those things, they will not like to do what? Some of them will have issues, will have problems accepting the Hebrew name of the Messiah. And that is what? That is the name that's going to do what? That's going to bring you back to what? To where you were. And that is the name of Yahushua. This is the name that our Heavenly Father, this is the name that is having the name of our Heavenly Father in him. Because he said it come in his Father's name. Yahushua, when you pronounce it, when you speak that name, you are calling on our Heavenly Father equally. Now let me show you something that happened in the book of Psalm, chapter number 91. To show you that there's power in it. Now, book of Psalms, chapter number 91. Let's start reading from verse 14. He said, because he has set his love upon me. Talking about those who have, you know, who have that love. You know, those who have that, you know, that morale of, you know, in them already. You know, because you've set your love upon the Most High. Listen to what he said he's going to do. He's going to give to you. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high. Because he has known my name. Now talking, because he has known my name, he shall call upon me and I will answer him. And I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. So his salvation is going to be shown to those who have interest. And that salvation is talking about Yahushua. You get it? You know, that salvation which he's talking about is because he has set his love upon him now in this contemporary time. The love which you have set on the Most High is to do what? Is to obey his voice. And when you do that, he's the one that is going to show you what his salvation. His salvation is Yahushua. Now let me show you something in verse 3 of the same Psalm, chapter number 91. He said here Psalms chapter 91 from verse 4. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and what? And buckler. You get it? His truth. Who is the truth? Do you remember what the Messiah said in the book of John chapter number 14 from verse John chapter number 14 from verse 6? He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except through me. That is to say, he is the truth of the whole world. When you accept the truth of who, what his name is, then that means, so those people who had issues with his name before will also have issues with him now. You see where it's going. So there's deep mystery in what, in the name. Talking about the name of Yehuda and the tribe of Yehuda are those people who were born, you know, who came out, you know, having the name of their own heavenly Father in them. They don't need any converts to know nothing. They were born that way, you know. So now you have the Father, because he said that what if my people who are called by my name, and those people are the tribe of Yehuda, and now you have those people who are also what, who accepted, you know, talking about at that time. Now those people, the people who accepted Yahushua, now do you know what that means? Then that means in the world to come, you are going to be born into the tribe of Yehuda. Did you have know how deep this is? Those people that accepted Yahushua now in the world to, in the world of Yahushua, in his own kingdom, then that means you are going to be born in what, in the tribe of Yehuda. And now when you are born into the tribe of Yehuda, you are now what? You are a worshipper of Yahuwah. I mean, you need to get this. This is deep. I don't know. You know, people, you need to, don't let this brainwash people who do not know how to divide what is written in the scripture to teach nothing. Yahushua came here to do what? To show us the way to the Father. And when you accept him, what you are automatically doing is you are accepting the word that was sent on the cosmos. Therefore, in his own kingdom, because he already said that his kingdom is not of this world. So in his own kingdom, you are going to be born in what? In the tribe of Yehuda. And now when you are born in the tribe of Yehuda, what? Who are you? You are a worshipper of Yahuwah. Definitely, you need not know any other conversion. This is why Yahushua came here. But people are here trying to do what? Trying to kick against what he has done. The most wonderful thing on the whole face of the universe. To show you the salvation. To even have the opportunity to hear the name of Yahushua in your ear. And you see people who still stay there and they're saying they are kicking against it. Who don't know the depth of what they are missing. The name of Yahushua is the name that our Heavenly Father has set on this cosmos. In other words, when you accept that name, you are going to be born in what? In the tribe of Yehuda. And when you are born into the tribe of Yehuda, you are the worshipper of Yahuwah. Here to give you the concrete understanding of the scripture, because it is in me. Hope you get the message, my dear listeners, and I pray the Most High be the one to do what? To open up your moral understanding, to be able to grasp the deep mysteries of the kingdom and of the scripture. Because it is time to give nothing but what the concrete understanding of what is written in the scripture. I say shalom to you all. Shalom.